If you're thinking about learning to program in 2025 or just getting started, you're probably asking yourself, is it still worth it? With newer and more capable AI models releasing what seems like every other week, and AI hype man telling people that the end of programming as a profession is near. And all of that during a time when tech companies are doing mass layoffs or temporarily stop hiring. Should you reconsider your career choices, or is it still worth learning to program in 2025? After all, software plays a massive role in the technology that powers our daily lives, and its influence is only growing. So if you want to make a difference in the modern world, understanding how those software systems work has long been known to be an extremely valuable skill. And a few years ago, it was also known to be a skill that can make you a lot of money quite quickly. But a lot has changed in recent years. The golden years of zero interest rates contributing to massive investments in the tech industry, and the global pandemic causing a hiring boom because everyone and everything went online, are over. While a coding bootcamp was enough to get you hired just a few years ago, in 2025, the tech job market is not what it once was, especially for entry-level positions. So, how valuable is programming in 2025 and beyond? And is it a skill that is still worth learning? To answer this question, I think we first need a common understanding of what programming even is. Because when most people think about programming, they only think about the task of actually writing the code. But the reality is, that is only a small part of what a programmer actually does. In fact, reports show that developers spend less than 1 hour per day actually coding on average. So what are they doing the rest of the day, except arguing whether they should use tabs or spaces in their codebases? The work of a software engineer involves a lot more than just writing the code, that ideally does what you want without bringing down the production server every few days. They need to understand and break down business requirements, discuss and research technical solutions for any given problem, and plan a software architecture that does not only fit the current requirements, but is also in line with the future roadmap of a product. And last but not least, they have to document everything so that LLMs can pick up on what's going on. When it comes to replacing developers, there's a common saying that goes something like, programmers will be replaced the moment that managers can accurately describe what they want, which makes fun of the massive communication gaps between managers and engineers. In fact, we even made up entirely new job positions like product managers and requirement engineers just because of that gap. Translating user requirements into a technical process is not an easy task, and I'm not even talking about writing the actual code. The biggest part of a development process is breaking down the problem into a structured and well-defined process. This requires a pretty good understanding of the technical system itself, which became painfully obvious to me when a very involved project manager once said to me, he does not understand why a certain feature is so difficult to build. It is simply an if this, then that. To be fair, we as engineers might not always do the best job of explaining all the technical implementations of a certain feature. But in the end, you can describe almost anything as a simple if this, then that. A bank, for example, is just if you want to transfer some money, then move it to another bank account. But in reality, it is obviously a lot more complicated than that. You have to deal with accounts and integrations in different banking systems, different currencies, exchange rates, money laundering detections, and even the fact that you might have amounts that are smaller than the smallest unit of every given currency due to exchange rates or fees. But a lot of those implementation details are not obvious to a non-technical person, which might also be the reason why they seem to think programmers can be replaced by LLMs altogether. On the other hand, you rarely see senior engineers freaking out about AI replacing software engineers, because they have seen this exact process over and over again so many times. And they have also seen the constant progress and improvements in tooling when it comes to software development in general. There is probably no other industry that is so incredibly obsessed with creating more and more abstractions to make things at least seemingly easier to understand. The programming languages that we use to write software today are specifically designed to make software easier to write and understand for humans. There is a good reason why the majority of programmers do not write C or assembly anymore, and it's not just a skill issue. Attempts to bridge that gap between natural language and technical implementation are not new at all, but they all ran into the same problems. Any natural language description of a program is inherently ambiguous, incomplete, and inconsistent, because words and sentences can have completely different meanings depending on the context. Figuring out what those gaps between natural language and technical implementation are is an essential part of a programmer's job. If you want to define what a program actually does, it has to be defined in a formal structure, like a programming language. We are constantly creating abstractions to describe those actions in shorter ways, but computers need precise instructions that they can perform step by step in the end, and there's no way around that. This is also why I don't see programming languages themselves going away anytime soon, especially not with LLMs who rely on the input data to do anything at all. What might change, however, is the way a lot of code is written. We had code generators for a long time now, and LLMs are the most advanced version of that. Where exactly will it go? Well, prediction is very difficult, especially if it's about the future. We are currently seeing mixed results about the usage of LLMs in general, suggesting a much higher productivity at the cost of reduced code quality. But let's assume that most of the code written in the future will be written by some sort of magical black box that we call AI. Why should you still learn programming if that's the case? Well, first of all, to actually have the black box produce the code that you want, you have to understand the basics of how to structure code. This might not matter in a small project, but trust me, it will in a bigger code base. And you will also have to fix the code it produces. LLMs are not even close to a failure rate that is small enough to produce bug-free code for complex features. And while it will certainly improve over the next years, the rate of improvement would have to be enormous, or as Neatcode put it in his "This video will change your mind about the AI hype."
You know that as you get better and better, it becomes harder and harder to improve. If you have a system with 99% availability and now you want to push that system to 99.9% availability, it seems like it's just a 1% improvement. It's not a 1% improvement. This is actually a 10x improvement, because the failure rate with a system that's up 99% of the time is just 1% of the time. With this system would be 0.1%. There's 10 times fewer failures.
But even if you think AI will be able to solve all of those coding problems soon, learning to program teaches you a skill that is extremely valuable in any professional career as well as in your daily life: problem solving. When you learn how to program, you will be constantly put in the position of figuring out how to break down a problem, identify the challenges, come up with solutions, implement them, and adapt them until you get closer to your goal. And you will fail many, many times over and over again. But it will teach you a skill set that will allow you to tackle a wide range of problems much more easily. And I'm not just talking about technical ones. Problem-solving skills are extremely useful when identifying underlying problems, trying to resolve some conflict, and overall make better and more informed decisions. It is exactly that skill set that makes IT professionals more likely to land a job than the average professional. Tech jobs are also still predicted to be among the fastest growing jobs over the next 5 years, even though a lot of them might not be traditional programming jobs. The technology landscape is constantly changing, and so are the methods that we use to create digital products and services. If you're ready to continuously adapt and learn new technologies, software engineering has a lot to offer. But it is also important to understand that it takes time to learn programming, and while AI might help you out with errors in the early stages of your learning process, if you don't try to understand the mistakes that you made, you will never develop a deeper understanding of software systems. And of course, there are also cases where I wouldn't recommend you to learn programming. If you're mainly looking for an easy way to get a well-paying job, you will probably struggle to find long-term fulfillment as a software engineer. But if you're interested in learning more about how software systems actually work, go ahead, and don't let yourself hold back by some AI hype man who moved on to the next bubble after their NFTs went up in flames. You will develop massively beneficial skills that will help you in every professional working environment. And realistically, once AI replaces software engineers, basically all of the office jobs will be obsolete. All that's left to do then is to either go farming or finally rise up and redistribute the massive accumulation of wealth to the masses. But why would you trust me? Obviously, I'm incredibly biased, because I want you to learn programming, so I can sell you those beautiful Astro themes that I've just released and that you can now buy on bufferthemes.com. Astro is the second most used meta framework and number one in interest, retention, and positivity according to the State of JavaScript Survey 2024. If you're looking to build a fast and beautiful website for your business, side project, or just for yourself, You can check them out at bufferthemes.com. And it also massively supports this channel. Speaking of, if you enjoyed this video, why don't you hit that subscribe button and like the video, and maybe check out Neatcodes, this video will change your mind about the AI hype. See you in the next video.